Brand new day, brand new lecture, and a brand new series of IDT for all you guys. Just recently, last night, ICI has come up with the exam timetable for July, and I hopefully you guys are doing really well with respect to studies. If you're revising IDT, this series of lectures, which one video is already uploaded for the first chapter, this is the second chapter, guys. One by one, just watch these videos, and you'll be super, super good with IDT. I've covered everything from the module. I've covered giving you great shortcuts. And also, if there's an examination question, I've tried to cover that as well in these series of IDT lectures. The second chapter, which is called supply. What is supply? What are the sections, subsections, clauses, schedule? Everything in this video has a shortcut. Watch it till the end. No matter which book you're referring to, doesn't matter, guys. Who you heard before in a lecture doesn't matter. As long as you're here and as long as you're willing to do it very well, let's do this revision lecture. If you're revising, the best way is to watch this revision lecture and then go to whichever book you want to, but we are following the module right away. Welcome to SMAT, guys, and chapter 2, Supply of GST. All right, so then what is supply, guys? What is supply? Just wonderfully go through this chapter with this revision lecture. What is supply? How does it impact? What are the sections? Everything right here we're covering. So be with me while we do this entire second chapter of GST. And again, whichever book you're referring to doesn't matter. We are looking at the module. We're covering everything from the module. Wait for it. Guys, GST, we take as an example, the electric bike company. This electric bike company, as the name suggests, they buy engines, they buy tires, they buy batteries, they make electric bikes, and they sell it to people like you and me. So they basically are suppliers of electric bikes. So this electric bike company and this electric bike is our example throughout the chapter. And this is basically a consumer whom they're selling the electric bike. Perfect. Now for supply, whether there is supply or not, the key word for you is GSS. You have to check in the exam if GSS exists, guys, then there is a supply. Otherwise, there is no supply. And if there is no supply, there is no GST. So the first thing under GSS is goods. So what is goods, guys? Goods is everything. The laptop that you're watching this from, the mobile phone that you're holding, the furniture that you're sitting on, everything is goods except IMS. Guys, goods is everything except IMS. As you heard it right, IMS is a shortcut, GSS is a shortcut. What is IMS? Immovable property is not goods. So if you sell your office or your house or after construction, if you sell any property, that is not subject to any GST. Any money, guys, money basically means any currency which you sell that is not subject to GST unless it has numismatic value. That means an old coin of 1980s. Or last securities on the share market, guys, when you buy shares, sell shares, or otherwise when you buy securities and sell securities, that is not subject to GST. And that's the reason when you buy a share, there is no GST. But when you go have dinner, there is GST. Next S is services. So if it's not goods, can it be services? Yes, services again means anything, guys, and everything except GIMS. Except which are goods, that is not covered in services. Except immovable property, again, that is not covered in services. Money is not covered in services and securities is not covered in the services. But guys, exchange of money. Example, you're going for a holiday abroad and you sell your Indian currency and buy US dollars. Then in that case, that exchange, that service of exchange is subject to GST. When you buy securities, on that securities, there is no GST, but the buying and selling that service, that brokerage, on that there is GST. So guys, the first G is done. What is goods? Goods is everything except IMS. Any movable property except IMS. Services, basically everything except GMIS. And now we can come to supply. GSS. But before we come to supply, guys, I just want to tell you a couple of people here. Guys, this guy here, the electric bike company, he is the supplier. Supplier is the one who makes the supply. So he's going to supply the electric bikes and he's a supplier. This guy here, he's the recipient. Recipient is a person who actually makes the payment. And in case there is no payment involved, which we'll see in supply chapter, when there is no consideration involved or no money involved, then the person who takes the supply or who receives the goods or the services is the recipient. So there's a supplier, there's a recipient. For the supply, this electric bike, the electric bike company will charge 1 lakh rupees, guys, plus GST. And this amount is called consideration, guys. So supplier is one thing, recipient is one thing, and this amount, which is called consideration, which is going to be paid, of course, by the consumer to electric bike company, guys, this consideration is the money. Money can be in terms of actual real money, or consideration can be in terms of money. It's worth also. That means you give me an electric bike and I'll do your auditing. That, or you give me an electric bike and I'll do your accounting. that quid pro quo, the word is quid pro quo. These words are important. Quid pro quo. That means you do something for me and I'll do something back for you. That is also consideration. So supplier, recipient, consideration, we understand. What is goods, what is services, we understand. And now let's go to supply. Guys, supply is what you see in normal sense. Supply means selling, yes. Supply means exchanging, yes. Supply means bartering, yes. Supply means giving something on rent, yes. All of this is supply. So supply is a very inclusive term because anything can be supply and everything can be supply. It's a very inclusive term. Example, when you go to buy the electric bike company, is it supply? Yes. If you exchange your old bike and or exchange three bikes and get your new bike, that exchange is also a supply. If you barter something, you give them gold and take an electric bike, even that is supply. And if they give it to you on rent, that bike for 1 month, even that is supply. So supply is a very exclusive, sorry, a very inclusive term. That means it can include a lot of other things. Are these definitions important from an exam perspective? No. But should you know them? Yes, because only if it's GSS, will there be any GST. Because without this, guys, if it's not goods, there is no GST, like selling an office. If it's not S, there is no GST. Example, services, if it's not there, then there's no GST. Or in that case, supply is not there. That is, there is goods, but you're not selling it. So then there will be no GST. So GSS has to be there for GST to apply. Next, guys, we come towards the sections. The sections have amazing shortcuts. You've seen mathematics, guys. I'll teach you tags through mathematics, and that's a promise today. Guys, the first section here is, what is a supply? What is a supply? For that, I'll give you an example. If electric bike company sells it a bike to customer, on the other hand, when you buy the electric bike, and let's say you're bored of it and you sell it on OLX, you go on OLX and you sell it, for which, whom is it a supply? Is it a supply for you because you're selling it on OLX? How do you determine supply is given in a section called section 7. Guys, section 7.1a. Section 7.1a says that for a supply to happen, A is equal to B plus C. That's the formula, guys. That's the shortcut. What is the shortcut? A is equal to B plus C. So for A to happen, that means for supply to happen, there should be B and C. Now let's see what this B is and let's see what this C is. Everyone, A is equal to B plus C. Guys, it should be for the purpose or for the furtherance of your business. If you're in the business of electric bikes and you're selling an electric bike, is it in the course of your business? Yes. Is it a furtherance of your business? Yes. Then B is there. But if you're selling it on OLX, then is it a course of your business? No, you're a student. That's not your business. Or you're a CA. That's not your business. So hence, guys, B is not present there. So B basically means in the course of business or furtherance of business, or B is business. And C is basically consideration. That means, guys, there should be some money or money is worth involved. OLX, also there is consideration, guys, but B and C both should be there. So let's now see, when electric bike company sells the bike, is there B? Yes. Is there C? Yes. Is it for the purpose of business? Yes. Is it for the purpose of consideration? Yes. Is there a consideration? Yes. So B and C supply. B and C is there, and hence that supply of electric bike company is considered a supply for GST. On the other hand, when you sell the bike on OLX, guys, is there B? No. There is C, but there is no B, and hence this cannot be supply. So when you sell on OLX, and it's not your business to sell. If it's your business to sell, guys, then there'll be GST. But if it's not your business to sell, there is no B, and hence this formula fails. If there's no B, the formula fails, and hence there will be no GST. So sell it on OLX, but you will not charge GST. This is 7.1a. Very, very simple, guys. A is equal to B plus C. There should be B, there should be C. Guys, consideration, you know, can be in money's worth also. It can be a quid pro quo also. Example, let's say there's a temple. And the temple asks you for donation and you pay them donation. Guys, is that a supply? Let's check. A is equal to B plus C. Is there a business? Is it a furtherance of a business? Maybe not, because there is no business of the temple. Or maybe because the business of the temple is to make you famous. Maybe. Is there a consideration? No. Consideration means two-way. There is no consideration. But on the other hand, guys, you tell them that I will give you money and you give me publicity. So change the name of your trust and call it, Saurabh Mutha Trust. Then in that case, is there a quid pro quo? Yes. So that donation will be a supply. Example, you give a footballer, there's a cricketer or a footballer who's very famous, and you gift him a new car. Is that a supply? A is equal to B plus C. Is it there? A is equal to B plus C. Is there a business? Yes, it is for the furtherance of your business. It will make you popular. But is there a consideration? No, there's no consideration. But if he decides to wear your company's name on his t-shirt, then is there a consideration? Yes. So then it becomes a supply. I hope you understand A is equal to B plus C. Now, is there a supply? Yes. There should be B also, guys. And there should be C. If both of them are there, only then it will be supply. So B should be there as well as C should be there. Only then it becomes supply. So 7A, 1A, A is equal to B plus C. Now, if it is supply, then section 7, 1A, 1A and 1A are basically close cousins. Once it is known that it is supply, 7-1A helps you figure whether it is supply of goods or whether it is supply of services. 7-1A helps you to figure out whether it is supply of goods or whether it is supply of services. But honestly, it does not matter because even goods are subject to GST and even services are subject to GST. But it's just good to know whether it's goods or whether it is service. All right. And for that, guys, we go to Schedule 2. And how do you remember? Wait for the shortcut, guys. Whether it is goods, 1, or whether it is services, 2. Between the two things, what it is, who tells you? Schedule 2. Because 2 signifies between these two things, what it is, Schedule 2 will tell you. So the how do you remember Schedule 2? Schedule 2 basically is only when it's 7-1A. That is it supply? Yes, it is supply. Is A is equal to B plus C? Yes, A is equal to B plus C. Electric bike company has sold the electric bike. So then 7-1A, which is the next section, tells you that go to Schedule 2 and figure out whether it's supply of goods or supply of services. So basically, Schedule 2 only tells you whether it's supply of goods or it is supply of services between the two, and hence Schedule 2. And guys, how will you figure out? It's a very and very simple thing. In fact, this figuring out whether it's goods or services is through one word called title. Is the title of the goods, title basically means ownership. Is the ownership of the goods being transferred to the person either today or tomorrow or later on? Is it going to be transferred? If the title is going to be transferred, then it is supply of goods. But if the title is not going to be transferred, it is supply of services. Example, when electric bike company sells you the bike, either it sells you normally when you pay the full price, or it sells you on EMI, or it sells you on higher purchase, whereby when you pay the last installment, it will become yours. Is the title being transferred? Yes, the title is being transferred. You are the new owner. Then it is supply of goods. But if they rent you the bike, for 1 month, is the title being transferred? No, they're still the owner. So in that case, it is supply of services. Let's take another example. When you sell an office, is that supply? No, because it's not goods only. But guys, when you rent an office, is the title being transferred? No title is being transferred, so it is supply of services. Let's take more examples. When you go to a restaurant, guys, when you go to a restaurant, they give you food also, that is goods also, and they give you service also of getting it to your table, cooking it for you, etc. So in that case, what it is, they have mentioned, guys, a certain few peculiarities. Example, restaurant. Restaurant is always going to be supply of services, so they've removed the confusion. Next. Works contract. What is works contract? Works contract is basically contracts where you tell someone to make furniture for you. You tell someone to do something for you, guys. Let's say you told someone to make furniture for you. Then in that case, a works contract. But he's giving you furniture also and making the furniture also. So goods also and services also. So they've clarified that this will be service. And guys, when the building is being constructed, you've not received the OC, you've not received the CC, that is occupation certificate, completion certificate, you've not received. Till then, if they supply, is it supply of goods or supply of services? It is under construction. So they're giving you construction services. So hence that will also till the CCOC, it is construction services, supply of services. After that's an immovable property. So there is no supply. There is no supply and there is no goods and there is no GST. So again, repeating, guys, 7-1A, A is equal to B plus C. There should be purpose of business and there should be consideration. Both should be there. If it's there, then whether it's goods or services, who tells you? Schedule 2. Between the two things, who tells you? Schedule 2 tells you. Whether it's goods or whether it's services depends upon title transfer. If the title is being transferred, then goods. If the title is not being transferred, then it is services. We'll look at it from the module as well, but this is how the two sections and Schedule 2 is over already. So A is equal to B plus C, 7-1A and Schedule 2. We've seen all of these and all these are linked to each other. So we have finished with these. All right, perfect. Title is what you look at. Guys, next. Now let's go to the next part. The next part or the next section, guys, is 7-1B. 7-1B is bahar se aa raha hai kuch. Guys, you are in India. and you want your office to be renovated. This is your office in India and you want it to be renovated. If you go to an architect in India, he will charge you service plus some fee plus GST. Let's say he charges you 10 lakh rupees for his architectural services. On that, he will charge you GST and it will become expensive. So what you do is you import those services from abroad. So what is 7-1-B targeting? 7-1-B does not talk about goods. It only talks about services, that too, which is coming from outside. And hence, B is Bahar Se. Guys, a shortcut for remembering B is Bahar Se. Bahar is basically outside India. So when it's coming from Bahar Se, 7-1-B comes into picture. Only services, not goods. Goods will be covered at CA finally. So when it's coming Bahar Se, 7-1-B, B plus C, do you require both? No, we don't require both because B is already there. In 7-1-B, we already have B. So whether we have B here or not does not matter. Guys. We don't necessarily need B. If it's there, great. Even if it's not there, even then it is great. So let's say you took some architect services from abroad. Let's say there's an architect abroad who's your friend and you tell him that, listen, I want to renovate my office. Can you supply services? He'd say, okay, I'll charge you 10 lakh rupees. You say, okay. Is that a supply? Please, let's see. Will 7-1-A cover that? No, because it's importation of services. You will not even go to 7-1-A. You will straight go to 7-1-B. B is Bahar Se. And for B, you need only C. Whether B is there or not, it's okay. Whether B is there or not, it's okay. But you definitely need C. Is there a consideration? Yes, 10 lakh. Is it for your business? Yes, you're renovating your office. Or if you're renovating your house, does not matter because here, guys, you don't need B necessarily. If it's there, great. Even if it's not there, you will still have supply. So 7-1-B only requires one thing, that is consideration. If there is consideration, there will be supply. Now let's take the same example, but your friend says, listen, you've been my best friend all throughout my life. I'm not going to charge you money. If he's not going to charge you money, guys, C is not there. And guys, then it is not a supply because you need C. If you're in 7-1-B, then you need C. Again, I'll repeat, guys, what is the formula for this? Again, B is equal to B plus C, but we don't necessarily need B here. We don't necessarily need B here. And 7-1-B, you will only and only look at when there is importation of services. 7-1-B is only and only to be looked at when there is importation of services. Any schedule to this? No schedule to this, guys. Thankfully, no schedule to this. So we're done with two sections, three sections actually, 7-1-A, A is equal to B plus C, which is the most common section in your exam. Next section was section 7-1-A, which tells you whether it's goods or services and which schedule do you look at, schedule 2, and you look at title transfer. That is the first part. Second part was 7-1-B, when it's Bahar Se, importation of services, not goods, only services when it's coming from outside. You need to have C. Whether B is there or not doesn't matter because 7-1-B does not require any B because B is already there. And now we look at the last one. That is 7-1-C. Guys, 7-1-C, C is already there. So you don't need C. Again, in this formula, just like in 7-1-B, B was there, so you didn't need B. In 7-1-C, you already have C, so you don't need C. But you need B. That means there should be a furtherance of business or in the course of business. When you don't need C, means there is no consideration, means, guys, that supply is happening free of cost. This is electric bike company. They are supplying the electric bike, but guys, there is no consideration. If there is no consideration, whenever the exam question says, there is some service, goods, electric bike, non-electric bike, motor car, whatever is the exam question, but if they say there is no consideration, you straight away ignore 7-1-A. Ignore 7-1-B and straight come to 7-1-C because C is the place which tackles when there is no consideration because for C, you do not require any C. So for C, you do not require any C. So first up, if the exam question says no consideration, will you go to 7-1-A? No, 7-1-B, no, straight 7-1-C where there is only and only requirement of business, that is, it should be for the furtherance of business. Now let's see which schedule covers it, guys. When there is no consideration, do you get even 1 rupee? No, you don't even get 1 rupee. Guys, no consideration means you've not even got 1 rupee. And that's the shortcut for schedule 1. 7-1-C is linked to schedule 1. And 7-1-C says that if there is no consideration, then to make it supply, it should be under schedule 1. How do you remember that? 1 means 1 rupee also you did not get. So that's why it is linked to 7-1-C. And schedule 1 says that related agent, you had a related person who was an agent. He He imported BA. He imported business assets. This is the shortcut, guys, for schedule one. Related agent imported BA. And if it's only these four things without consideration, then it will be supply. As long as there is business, guys, B has to be there. Let's take an example, guys. Related. There's a shortcut here also. But let's say electric bike company's son, the owner's son, guys. Let's say this is electric bike company. And let's say there's a partnership firm or a sole proprietorship firm. And a relative of theirs comes and sees the bike and loves the electric bike and says, listen, I want this one. But of course, I'm your relative. Of course, you're not going to charge me money. He says, no, no, I cannot charge you money. So he gives the electric bike, but he doesn't charge money. If there's no money, guys, then you'll go to 7-1-C. And 7-1-C says, if it's only part of these four, then it will be supplied. Is it part of these four? Yes, you've given it to a related person. So if you give it to a related person, also a distinct, deemed distinct person, which you will see now, then in that case, even if there is no consideration, it will still be a supply. So when electric bike company gives the bike to a related person without consideration, it is still a supply. And it's still a supply means there will be GST. So even though he doesn't get money, he will have to pay GST to the government. Government says, we don't care whether you have no consideration, but we want GST on this. Now, what is related? Let me give you a shortcut, guys. What is related? The shortcut for related is a family can cope 25%. See, your family is good to you. If you crack the stupidest jokes, if you are very, very stupid also, they will cope with you 25%. Not fully, but they will cope with you 25%. That's the shortcut. Remember, relative. Here, a sole agent. Guys, A is sole agent. A sole agent is a related person. Yes, a sole agent. That means an agent who's only selling your goods is a sole agent. Is a related? Yes. Your family, is it related? Yes. What is family, guys? Your spouse plus your children always. This is always. But your parents plus your grandparents plus your siblings, only if they are dependent on you, then they become family and then they become related. We're looking at the definition of what is related, who is related people, and the shortcut is a family can cope 25%. A is agent, F is family, family is spouse and children always are a family. And guys, parents, grandparents, and siblings are a family only if they're dependent on you. The exam question will tell you about. Next, C is control. When someone controls you, or you control someone, C and C. When someone controls you or you control someone, those people are related. Next, O. Officers of one company. Let's say you are the CEO or someone is the CEO of the same company or officer of the same company. Or partners in the same firm are related person. So if one partner sends some goods to the other partner without consideration, it's a related person, yes, and there will be GST. Officers, partners. E is employer-employee, guys. Employer-employee. So if an employer gives something to the employee free of cost, but there's an exception here, which we will talk about, that is also a related person, that will be also subject to GST. And last, 25%. Guys, 25% means if a person has common shareholding of more than 25% in two companies, let's say Mr. A holds 26% in electric bike company and 26% in another company, then those two entities are also related to each other. So basically, this is equity share capital having voting share. These people are related persons. A family can cope 25%. Agent, family members, control, officers, partners, employees, and 25%. Besides this, if you're also giving it to a deemed distinct person, guys, who are deemed distinct persons? We'll see ahead in a chapter called registration that you need registration in GST state-wise. So if you're in Maharashtra, you will have one registration. If you're in Karnataka, you need another registration. Let's say I have a textile business in Maharashtra and Karnataka. I will need registration in both states because GST registration is state-wise. And let's say from Maharashtra, my godown, I send something to Karnataka, which is my another shop only, but free of cost. So 7-1-C, yes, because no consideration. Is there a business? Yes, but it's related to person. Yes, it's a deemed distinct person. Guys, these two entities are called deemed distinct persons under section 25, we will see ahead. But deemed distinct basically means two entities under the same pan and different states. They are basically deemed distinct persons, and any supply you make to them without consideration, that will also be subject to GST because schedule 1 tells. So those are related persons. Next is agent. Nice. Related persons is done. Let's move to agent. If you are basically supplying goods to an agent, if you are electric bike company and you don't sell goods directly to the consumers, guys, you first sell it to an agent or you supply it to an agent, and the agent in turn sells it to the consumers, then we are talking about this transfer from the electric bike company to the agent. Is this supply? If it's with consideration, then there is no point only to discuss it because A is equal to B plus C, which is fulfilled, and then there is supply. But what if there is no consideration? If there is no consideration, you go in 7(1)(c) because you're not required C. And in that, guys, if a principal supplies to an agent, then that is a supply, even if there is no consideration. An electric bike company will have to pay a GST on that to the government. But agent is not someone who will just take your goods and sell it under your name. Agent is someone who basically sells it in under his name. So when the consumer buys, the consumer will get an invoice of the agent, and that is the agent. If I just tell someone that, listen, here is a bike, just go and sell it in my name, then he is not my agent for Schedule 3 purposes or Schedule 1 purposes, my bad. So Schedule 1, which has no consideration, related agent, imported BA, are the only four situations you have to see. One situation is over. If you give it to related persons or deemed distinct persons without any consideration, even then it will be supplied as long as B is there, business is there. If you give it to an agent free of cost, even then there will supply. And same thing, guys, if agent gives it to the principal, again, without any consideration, even then there is supply. Guys, agent, there's a special agent also called Del Keder agent. I'll give you a shortcut here also. Del Keder agent, how the shortcut? He deals with for you also, and he collects money also. Del Keder agent, he deals also for you. That means he sells goods also, and he collects money also. He promises you that he will collect the money and give it to you. That's a promise, and that's why he's doing more things, two things, and that's why he charges higher commission. Now, when the Del Keder agent sells it to the consumer, first up, let's say he sells a bike worth 1 lakh, and he promises to pay you that 1 lakh by collecting from the consumer. If the consumer does not pay, then he will pay it to you and he will charge the customer a certain interest. So now, guys, the value is 1 lakh of the bike and the interest, let's say, is 10,000 rupees. Now, my point of discussing right now is that GST will be charged on 1 lakh or on 1 lakh 10,000. Will GST also be charged on a 10,000? They say that if the agent is raising the invoice, and he only is giving the loan to the consumer and charging interest, then it will be added. But if the invoice is raised by electric bike company, then on that 1 lakh, there will be no, only GST on 1 lakh, not on 1 lakh. Perfect. So again, coming back to Del Keder agent, no. Coming back to agent point, if it's an agent basically he has his own invoice and sells it under his own invoice, then he's an agent, and giving goods to an agent or taking it from an agent without consideration is also subject to supply. There will be GST on that. That is a related agent. Next, imported BA. Guys, again, we're coming to imported Bahar Se. We've already dealt with Bahar Se, but this one is without consideration. Again, you're here, guys. Again, it's your office. Again, you're getting architectural services, but now, guys, this time, you're getting it done from your brother who is abroad, who's an architect. So he said, listen, I'm not going to charge you. I'm your brother. So if there is no consideration, will you go to 7(1)(b)? No, you will go to 7(1)(c). In 7(1)(c), importation of services also covered because related agent imported BA. So if it's consideration, then you'll go to 7(1)(b). But if there is no consideration, you'll come to 7(1)(c) because C does not require any C. And now when you're in C, ask yourself, 7(1)(c) does not require C but requires B. Is it for the purpose of your business? Yes, office, it is for the purpose of my business. So this is supply. On the other hand, guys, if you take your brother's architectural services to renovate your house, then in that case, which section will you go under 7(1)(c) because there is no consideration here? And is it for the furtherance of business? No. So this will not be a supply. So importation of services can go under 7(1)(b) also if there is consideration, or 7(1)(c) if there is no consideration. But this has to be from a related person. This has to be from a related person. Just one additional condition. This importation of services has to be from a related person. And then, of course, 7(1)(b)(c), you'll have to see the same way. Again, I repeat. So if it's coming from a brother who's a related person, then you check 7(1)(c) is equal to B plus C. We don't require C. You only need B, but there should be a business purpose. And last, guys, is BA, that is business asset. if you supply your business asset to someone without consideration, again, if you supply your business asset to someone without consideration, is that a supply? Example, you know, your best friend came to your shop and he's like, congratulations, you've made electric bike company. Congratulations, electric bike company. Great job. You are very, very happy with your friend. You know, he's your childhood best friend. So he says, listen, I want to gift you a bike. And you gift him a bike worth 1 lakh. Of course, you don't take money from him. And because you don't take money from him, it's under 7-1-C. You go under 7-1-C. 7-1-C, as you know, does not require C. It requires B. Is there B? Yes, there is business. Because this is for the furtherance of your business. So it should be first a permanent transfer. You cannot give him for a day and take the bike back. So it should be a permanent transfer. Is it a permanent transfer? Yes, it is a permanent transfer. And second thing that you should note, guys, that on this bike, you should have taken ITC. Guys, on the engine, on the batteries, on the tires, when you paid GST, did you take credit of it? If you've taken the credit, which you will see in ITC chapter, but if you know credit, you know credit, guys. If you've taken credit on it, then the government says you've taken credit on it. Now you're supplying it without consideration. So where is my GST? So we want GST on it. So this will be supplied. Just summarizing, guys, this last one, schedule one. Everyone be with me. Just summarizing this very, very quickly. So when will you go under 7-1-C? When there is no consideration, then is when you will go under 7-1-C. C is when there is no consideration. But there should be business. Yes, it should be business purpose. It cannot be empty, guys. The formula has to be there. So B has to be there. And for that, you'll go to schedule one. Why? Because not even 1 rupee you're getting. So schedule one, related agent imported BA. Related agent imported BA. Is it a related person or a deemed distinct person? What's the shortcut for that? A family can cope 25% or deemed distinct persons. If you're giving it to them free of cost, then it will be a supply. Agent, if a principal is giving it to the agent, agent, remember, has to have his own invoicing. Then that is a supply or reverse also. Even if it's without consideration, guys, all this is without consideration. If you're importing some services, again, goods are not covered here. Goods will be covered at CA finally. If you're importing some services, but this time there's no consideration, they come here, but there should be a business purpose. Renovation of your home will not count here. Office will count here. And last, business asset, if you transfer, any permanent transfer or disposal of business asset, permanent, yes. And have you taken ITC on it? Yes. The government says you've taken the credit. What about my GST? So you will have to pay GST on this. So this will be supplied. So guys, 7-1-A done, which is linked to schedule 2, because whether it's goods or services, two things. 7-1-B done, bahar se, when it's getting services. And B for B, you don't require B. And 7-1-C done, where you don't require any C, that is no consideration. So guys, 7-1-A, B and C completely done. Schedule 1 done, schedule 2 done. And now let's go to schedule 3. Schedule 3 is my favorite schedule. I'll tell you why. First up, how do you remember what is schedule 3? Schedule 1, I told you 1 rupee also you're not getting. So that is schedule 1, no consideration. Schedule 2 is between goods and services. Which one to choose? That is schedule 2. And schedule 3 is my favorite because, guys, this, if it's neither goods or it's neither services. Guys, if it's neither goods or neither goods nor services, then what is it? It is the third thing, which is no GST. Schedule 3 is a list of those goods and those services which are neither goods under GST, neither services. And what is the third thing? If it's not goods also, if it's not services, what is the third thing? Third thing, there is no GST. And schedule 3 is those third things. Basically, it's a negative list. Negative list means on these things, there is no GST. Everyone, all eyes, attention on the shortcut. Employee, partner, director. So there was an employee, there was a partner of a firm, and there was a director. What did they do? They moved constitutional court for what? For license. They moved constitutional court for license. Why did they require a license? What license did they require? They moved constitutional court for license for AC burial of MPs. So that member of parliaments, member of legislative assemblies, member of panchayats, they can be buried in an AC crematorium. So that's a shortcut, guys. Employee, partner, director, move constitutional court for license of AC burial of MPs. Let's see what this talks about. Guys, please remember this is a very happy section. Why happy? Because this is neither goods nor services. That means there is no GST and this is Schedule 3. First one. An employer or employee giving services. Guys, tomorrow you'll be CAs, you'll be working in offices. When you give services to your masters or do you give services to your employers, then in that case, there will be no GST. Yes, there is no GST. And guys, as you know, employee gives services to employer. He will pay you money, but will you charge GST on that? No GST because Schedule 3. Next, partner guys, when they provide services to the partnership firm and partnership firm pays them any salary, etc., again, no GST. When a director who's again an employee of an organization, they provide services, but this director has to be an employee director when they provide services to a company. As Mukesh Ambani is a director of Reliance, he's also an employee of Reliance. When he provides services and he takes salary, on that there is no GST. Moved. Any movement of bus, truck, lorry, crane, aircraft, there is no GST. What do I mean, guys? Electric bike company supplies their bikes in a tempo. The tempo goes from Bombay to Pune, the Bombay to Bangalore. The tempo goes from to supply. The movement of the tempo, there is no GST. On the goods inside, there is GST, but on the movement of these vehicles, etc., no GST, that is movement. Constitutional post, like services provided by MPs, services provided by MLAs. Guys, on these constitutional posts, including director of a chairman or a member of a government entity. There is a chairman, director, member of a government entity. On that also, these constitutional posts, they provide services, they work for you and me, and they earn money on that, there is no GST. Guys, when your high courts, supreme courts, district courts, they provide you services. What services? They give you justice, that's a service. Legal services, on that, there is no GST. Guys, you know, alcohol is Jain from the first chapter. So on alcohol, there is no GST, but even on alcohol licenses, if you apply for a license for alcohol, and let's say the license costs 1 lakh rupees, on that license also, there is no GST. Actionable claims. Now, what is actionable claim? Guys, I won a lottery or 10 lakh rupees. That's an actionable claim because I can demand that money. I have given you 10 lakh rupees as a loan because you told me you will give it to me in 6 months. I can demand that money. That is unsecured debt. That's an actionable claim. So actionable claim basically is a right to demand something because it's your right, it's your money, you can demand it back. That's an actionable claim. Actionable claim, guys, are subject to GST, but only and only those on lottery, betting, and gambling. If there is lottery, if there is betting, if there is gambling, only those three, guys, please remember, only lottery, betting, gambling, these three are subject to GST. Otherwise, there is no GST on other actionable claims. Example, when I give you a loan of 3 lakh rupees, do I charge you 3 lakh plus GST? No. So those actionable claims, there is no GST. But when I sell lottery, is there GST? Yes, lottery is an actionable claim. On that, there is GST. Lottery, betting, gambling, there is GST. For other actionable claims, there is no GST. Please remember, actionable claim means unsecured debt. If someone gives you a house and you give a loan to them, that is not actionable claim because that's a mortgage claim. Next, on burial services, on crematorium, on ambulance taking someone to the crematorium, on that there is thankfully no GST. And guys, when MPs, MLAs, panchayats, etc., when they provide services, thankfully there is no GST. So employee, partner, director, they move constitutional court for what? For a license for AC burial of MPs. On these things, there is no GST. That is Schedule 3. Of course, guys, Schedule 3 also talks about immovable property, but you already know, guys, why immovable property there is no GST? Because immovable property is not goods only. If it's not goods, then how can there be GST? So I'm not discussing that here. Employee, partner, director, move constitutional court, license for AC burial of MPs, no GST. Let's quickly summarize, guys. There are three sections. 7.1a, which says A is equal to B plus C, which is linked to 7.1a, which will tell you whether it's goods and services, which will link to Schedule 2, because whether it's goods or whether it's services. 7.1b, bahar se, does not require B. If it's there, okay, not there, okay, but require C, consideration should be there. And this one, there is no schedule. No, there is no schedule. 7.1c is when there is no C, no consideration, then you see 7.1c. And for that, there is a schedule. Yes, there is Schedule 1, when you don't even get 1 rupee. And guys, 7, and then there is Schedule 3, which is basically a general schedule which tells whether it's not goods, when it's not services, what it is. It is Schedule 3, the third thing, that is negative list, no GST on this. This is how wonderfully you will remember schedule 1, schedule 2, schedule 3, 71A, 71B, and 71C. Guys, next we come to composite and mixed supply, which is section 8. Section 8 says that supplies can be composite or supply can be mixed. The best way to do it is through an example, guys. I'll tell you the example. You go to buy a phone, and that's worth 10,000 rupees. And the phone comes with battery and charger. Of course, it should come with battery and charger, right? Naturally, it is bundled. It's a natural bundle. Guys, it's a natural bundle. Yes, it's a natural bundle because without the battery, how can I use the phone? Without the charger, how can I use the phone? Unless you're buying an Apple phone. So it's a natural bundle. Yes, it's a natural bundle. And is there a principal supply? Yes. Principal supply is the phone. You went to buy the phone. So if it's naturally bundled and there is a principal supply, then please tell me what GST rate will you apply? Will you apply a mobile phone rate of 18% or charger rate of 28% or battery rate of 5%? Which one will you apply? As you will apply the rate of principal supply. And this is told by Section 8 composite supply. That when the supply is composite, composite means when it's naturally bundled and there is a principal supply, then in that case, what is the supply? The supply is basically the rate which is applicable on the main supply. Guys, you buy a laptop and the laptop comes with a laptop cover. It's again a composite supply. You buy a car and comes with tire. You buy a laptop and it comes with warranty. All these are composite supplies. So what is the main supply? The principal supply, that rate will apply. But guys, your 18th birthday and your parents went to get you a gift. And they saw a hamper. There was a mobile phone in that hamper. There were chocolates in that hamper. There was a video game in the hamper. There was a PlayStation or an Xbox in the hamper. So it was a hamper of many, many different things. Now, let's say the mobile phone is chargeable at 18%. The chocolates are chargeable at 28%. And let's say the video game is chargeable at the rate of 12%. Now, which rate will apply? Please tell me, is this a natural mix? No, it's not a natural mixture. And is there one principal supply? No, all of them are main supplies. There's no one principal supply. And hence the highest rate will be applied as a punishment. So what should I do in this case? In this case, the best thing would be to do is buy them different. Some examples which are given in the module, which I want to discuss with you, as you go and buy a toothpaste and they give you a soap free. Soap and toothpaste both for 100 rupees, guys. What rate will apply? It's not a natural bundle. It's not a natural bundle. Even soap, even toothpaste with toothbrush is not a natural bundle. So please, you have to apply the higher rate because it's a mixed supply. You go to a hotel and the hotel, they give you breakfast. Is that a composite supply? Yes, that is a composite supply. So what is the principal supply of room? And that that rate will be applicable. So please ask yourself whether it's a natural supply or whether it's an artificial supply. If it's a natural supply and you can identify the principal supply, that rate will apply. The best example is mobile with charger and battery. Guys, that is section 8. I'm quickly going to the module now. Let me quickly go to the module and solve some sums. And let's take the module as well. All right, quickly, let's go through the module. Here is the module, guys. I've just highlighted the important parts. So the introduction is perfectly okay. What is the definition of goods? Everything except IMS. What is family? A family is yourself, your spouse and children always. Parents, grandparents, and brothers and sisters only if they're dependent on you. What is a business, guys? Business means anything which you do, including a clubhouse, or a clubhouse is for the benefit of members. Even that is a business. So business is a very, very wide definition. Then the next definition is consideration. Any payment in money or money is worth also. Actionable claim is anything that they have a right to get. Only lotteries, betting, and gambling. Only that is subject to GST. What is services? Everything except GIMS, goods, immovable property, money, and securities, not services. What is the recipient? Someone who's paying for the goods. If there is no consideration, someone who's receiving those goods or services is the recipient. Supplier, you know. Section 7 and 7, 8 are the supply sections. 1, 2, and 3 schedules, you already know. Schedule 1, no consideration, not even 1 rupee. 2 is goods or services, and schedule 3 is not goods, not services. What is the third thing? No GST. As we look at here from 7, 1, 8, there should be a consideration and it should be for the furtherance of business. 7A, 1A, A is equal to B plus C. There are some examples here which will be good to go through. Be with me. I'm taking you through the entire thing. Whatever is important, sale or transfer is also supply. Barter and exchange is also supply. License, rental, etc. is also supply. So I told you supply is a very, very wide term. Next, guys, we move ahead. Donations received. I've already discussed the example. Artworks sent. Let's discuss this one, guys. You're a painter, you send some artwork to an exhibition. Is there a supply when you send it? No, because there is no supply. You've not sold it. Once those artworks are sold, then A is equal to B plus C because it's further on of your business and there is a consideration. When you supply to the exhibition, there is no consideration and hence there is no supply. Artwork is discussed again in this highlighted part. And it should be for the furtherance of any business, guys. Selling on OLX is not business. And hence, guys, here the seventh example. Rishabh buys a car and he sells the car to a car dealer, guys. That is not his business and hence there is no supply. Manikarnika sold her jewelry to a jewelry shop. That is not a furtherance of business. So for her, there is no supply. If there is no supply, there will be no GST. Moving ahead, guys, to the next part. I've already highlighted 7-1-B is when importation of services, guys, bahar se aa raha hai. In 7-1-B, doesn't matter if it's B or not. But there should be C. Yes, there should be C. All right. Next, guys, is 7-1-C. 7-1-C is when there is no consideration. You will check 7-1-C. In 7-1-C, there are four things related agent imported BA. The first one they've discussed is BA. There should be a permanent transfer and you should have taken ITC on that. Example, Drew gives old laptops which are used for his business to his friend free of cost. Guys, you have an old laptop on you which you've taken credit, you've given it to a friend free of cost. That is not okay. On that, there will be GST. Why? Because it's a business asset. First of all, 7-1-C because no consideration. And then is it business asset, permanent disposal? Yes. Have you taken ITC on that? Yes. So it will be subject to supply and there will be GST. Supply between related person or distinct person. Who's related? A family can cope 25% is related and deemed distinct person you already know. Next, guys, supply. Moving ahead, guys, supply stock transfers between two entities. I told you from Bombay to Bangalore, if I transfer my stock, is that supply? Yes, even though there is no consideration, but this is between deemed distinct person, so there will be supply. Very easy, guys, if you remember the shortcuts. Gift by employer to employee, this is an exception. Let's discuss it now, guys. Generally, guys, gifts are free. So they should be taxed because let's say a gift is given. So there is 7-1-C because it's no consideration. In that is a related person. Yes, employer, employee is related. So there should be supply, there should be GST. But up to 50,000 rupees, they exempted. Up to 50,000 gift by employer to employee over 1 year period, there is no supply. That's an exception. Principal to agent is a supply, even if it's without cost. As agent is someone who issues an invoice. Dell Cater agent is someone who deals also, someone who collects money also. That is DNC, Dell Cater agent. Next, but guys, someone who just sells it in your name, he's not an agent. He has to supply an invoice in his name, then only he becomes an agent. And last, guys, importation of services again discussed here, but here it will be when it's no consideration, then it goes in 7-1-C. If it's from a related person and for the purpose of business, yes, there will be GST. Guys, free samples and gifts. If you give free samples, where it is coming, of course, it will come in 7-1-C. And will it be taxed only if it's related agent imported B? Buy one, get one free. Guys, you buy one electric bike, you get one more free. So you get two electric bikes for 1 lakh rupees. Where does it fall? 7-1-A, because is there a business? Yes. Is there a consideration? Yes. So don't get confused by these fancy terms. That will still be supply and there will be still GST, of course, on 1 lakh rupees. Now, guys, this is 7-1-A, 7-1 capital A, which says whether it is goods or whether it is service. That depends on basically whether the title is being transferred or not. That is Schedule 2. If you sell ready-made garments, title is transfer, supply of goods. If you sell machinery, then on rent, guys, no title transfer, supply of services. This is a whole list of supply of goods or services. Very, very easy as long as you track title. Only think of construction services, that is supply of services. A restaurant is supply of services. Works contract is supply of services. Those are exceptions because there is goods also and services also. So there is some confusion. So don't worry. Guys, that confusion is solved because they have told you that this is supply of services. Moving ahead, guys, tenancy rights, something that we've not discussed, we're discussing here only. Guys, tenancy right basically means you live in a house which is not yours, but you were living in the house on rent for so many years, so you got tenancy rights. Now that rights, when you sell, guys, this is supply of services. That is an exception. Remember it as an exception. That is supply of services. Will there be GST? Yes, but supply of services. Otherwise, guys, you would think it's an immovable property. No, it's supply of services and there will be GST. And guys, my favorite one, Schedule 3. Schedule 3 is a negative list where there is no GST, guys. Remember, employee, partner, director, move constitutional court for what? For license for AC burial of MPs. Employer, employee. So when employee provides services to employer, there is no GST. And employer sends goods to employee. Again, guys, 50,000 rupees is okay. About that, there will be GST. Above that, on the entire amount will be GST. If the amount is above that, the entire amount will be subject to GST. By a court or a tribunal, there will be no GST. Functions performed by MPs, MLAs, member of panchayat, member of municipalities has no GST. Chairman or member of director of a body established by the government, no GST. That is all a part of that shortcut. Funeral, burial, crematorium, or transportation of the deceased person, no GST. Sale of land, I've not discussed, guys, because sale of land basically means removal property, and removal property is not good, so not good means no GST. Actionable claims, AC, only lottery betting gambling will be GST, otherwise no actionable claim is GST. Guys, alcoholic liquor license, if you remember the sentence on that license also, there is no GST. Interstate movement, if there is movement of these modes of conveyance, like the tempo going, the truck going, bus going, trailer, aircraft going, on that movement of those goods, there's no GST. Unless, guys, you're selling the tempo. If you're selling the tempo, of course, there is supply of goods. All right. Then composite and mixed supply, very, very simple. We'll just take some examples of composite and mixed supply on the screen right away, guys. Mobile sold with batteries, mixed composite supply. Catering on board an aircraft is also mixed supply. Composite supply, because they're naturally bundled, guys. Principal supply is the aircraft travel. Perfect. Always remember, there should be natural bundle and there should be a principal supply for it to be a composite supply. Perfect. This is just recapping the entire thing. And let's go to a couple of questions, guys, right away. Let's go to a couple of questions. And the entire module we've covered, guys. Trust me, if you read the entire module, we've covered each and every part of the entire module. All right. Mehraj and Company wishes to commence the business of supplying ready-made garments within Punjab and in the neighboring states of Delhi and Haryana. Guys, within Punjab means they are in Punjab and they want to supply within Punjab. Then that's intrastate, CGST, SGST. And neighboring states means IGST. Kindly state as to what is the taxable event. Guys, taxable event is supply. 71A, 71B, 71C, Section 8. Simple. Damodar Private Limited, registered in Delhi, has transferred some goods to its branch, transferred registered in West Bengal, so that the goods can be sold from the branch. These goods have been transferred without any consideration. The moment you see the word without any consideration, 71C. And that will be supply only if it's related agent imported BA. This is related, guys, because deemed distinct persons, related persons are transferring without consideration, definitely a supply. So will there be GST? Yes, there will be GST. Prithvi Associates is engaged in the supply of taxable goods. It inquires from its tax advisor as to whether any activity can be related to supply even if made without consideration. Yes. Even if made without consideration, Schedule 1 says 4 activities can be related as supply. As you know, the 4 supplies, related agent imported BA. Transfer of title or possession is necessary for transaction to constitute a supply of goods. Exactly, yes. Title is necessary to be transferred either today or on higher purchase later also. But title, if it's transferred today or later on, that is supply of goods. Guys, we have to figure out whether this is under Schedule 1 or not. That means, guys, Schedule 1 is related agent imported BA. Suleika Manufacturers has a factory in Delhi and a depot in Mumbai. Both the establishments are registered, basically means they are deemed distinct persons. Finished goods are sent from the factory in Delhi to Mumbai without consideration, 71C. Yes, there is supply because it's supply to related persons. Raman is an architect in Chennai. His brother who settled in London is a well-known lawyer. Raman has taken legal advice, guys, bahar se aa raha hai. Will I go to 71B? No. Because, guys, this is without consideration. This is without consideration. So you'll go to 71C. And is it for the purpose of business? No, it's a family dispute. So hence, there will be no GST. Would your answer be different in the above case? Raman has taken the advice in respect to the business unit in Chennai. Business unit means, is it business purposes? Yes, so there will be GST. Next, guys, for the following, tell us whether it's supply of goods or supply of services. That means Schedule 2. Renting is supply of services. Goods forming part of business assets are transferred. That means title is transferred, supply of goods. Transfer of right in goods. Right in goods means transfer of goods. That means title is transferred, supply of goods. Transfer of title in goods, supply of goods. The moment you see title is transferred, that's supply of goods. Next, again, is it a supply of goods or services? Let's see. Temporary transfer or permitting the use or enjoyment of any IPR. As temporary transfer also means title is being transferred, so supply of goods. Supply of goods only, as said, so supply of goods. Any treatment or process which is applied to another person's goods, someone's textile you got and you dyed it. In that case, guys, title is not transferred, so it's supply of services, and transfer of title is supply of goods. The goods are supplied on higher purchase basis, guys. If the goods are supplied on higher purchase basis, in that case, title will be transferred later on, so that still is supply of goods. Next. There's a lady called Miss Srinathi, we'll call her Miss S. She received some interior decoration services from her residence located in Bandra, for her residence located in Bandra, residence is from Mrs. Rachel, Mr. Rachel of Sydney. Like she's paid $5,000. She's paid some money. Bahar se service aa raha hai 71B. There is consideration. Yes, consideration. Guys, there should be B for that. No, B is not required. So this one will be subject to GST. Yes, because there is C and B is not required. Again, she's getting some services, but this time, guys, it's for her residence and from her brother. And did not pay any consideration. So now it will be 71C. Related agent imported BA. Imported from a related person, yes. And it should be for the purpose of business. This is for residence, so no GST. But if she had got it for a business premises, then there will be GST. I hope you understood this. A hotel provides 4 nights, 3 days package with breakfast, guys, composite supply, principal supply, stay. A toothpaste company has affected the scheme of free soap. There is free soap, but that is mixed supply because there is no natural supply in this case. All right. Guys, here in this case, Gagan Engineering Company for providing some repair work. They are sending container trucks equipped with items like repair equipment, etc. This transportation, this movement of trucks, guys, movement of trucks is in Schedule 3. Movement of trucks is not subject to GST. On that service, he can charge GST because that's supply of services. All right. Guys, there's a company which is giving buy one, get one free. Guys, buy one, get one free. Still, you're buying something, right? So 71A is equal to B plus C. Is it for the furtherance of business? Yes. And is there a consideration? Yes. Even if it's a low consideration, there is a consideration. So this one will be supplied. And with that, guys, we've completed the entire chapter of supply 71A, A is equal to B plus C, Schedule 2. 71B, Bahar se services, importation of services, no schedule, but B does not require B, C should be there, there should be consideration. And 71C means there is no consideration, but business is required. So in that case, you go to Schedule 1. Why? Because Schedule 1, you didn't even get one. And whether it's not good, when it's not services, what is the third thing? Third thing is Schedule 3. All and everything done here through shortcuts. I hope you understood this well. Do more and more sums. Revise, do more sums. And next chapter will be on tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed this and do very well, guys. All the best.